In order to get you more familiar with Ontraport, I'm going to take you on a tour of the administration and account details areas of your account. There are a lot of options and settings in these two sections, and you'll get a deeper dive into a lot of this in other videos, but let's just cruise through so we know what's here. Let's start with the account details section. To get there, go to your profile icon in the upper right-hand corner and click Account. This screen is broken into a few different sections, so let's talk about each one. Your current account details shows you information about your account subscription, such as your original sign-up date, your subdomain, your current plan and cost. Here you're also going to find your billing and credit details, like your next charge date, SMS credits, and a tally of how many emails you've sent out this billing cycle. Next, let's take a look at content packages. This section shows you any content packages from the Ontraport Marketplace that you're currently subscribed to. You'll learn more about the Ontraport Marketplace in future lessons. The Need to Cancel section is where you can cancel your subscription with us, but I suggest avoiding this area of the app for obvious reasons. Invoices is where you'll find your monthly invoices by year and month. Click on any individual invoice to see the details. In Got Questions, there are some basic admin-related FAQs that you might find helpful. That just about covers the account details screen. So now let's move on to the administration section. To get there, go to your profile icon again and click on administration. This area is all about account settings and features. Notice that along the left side, there are a series of tabs and a search bar for quick access to specific tools. These options do get rearranged from time to time, so if you don't see something where I'm showing it today, just do a quick search to find it. Let's go over what's inside each tab. In the Data tab, there are tools designed to help you manage the data inside of your account. The File Manager is where you upload, delete, or download any of the files that you need. You'll use it to upload digital files and create download links so that you can send these out to your customers. Keep in mind that this is much better for your email deliverability than sending attachments. Similar to the File Manager is the Video Manager, and this is where you can upload videos to use on your pages. Next, Tracked Links is where you'll create and manage your tracked links. These links will go into your web pages or emails and tell you who clicked on what. They can also be used for some pretty neat automation. The SMS section is where you'll manage phone numbers used for SMS messages throughout your account. Just a quick note, using SMS numbers in Ontraport does cost a little extra. Custom objects is where you'll go to create and manage your various objects and relationships. This is a pretty hefty topic on its own, so check out our lesson on custom objects for more information about this incredibly powerful feature. Exported lists. Every time you export a list of contacts, a copy of that export is saved here so that you can re-download it later. Partner program links. This is your personal partner link that you can actually use to promote Ontraport to your friends. And if any of them sign up, you'll receive a payment. Lead scoring is where you'll manage the lead scoring rules for your system. The dashboard is where you'll manage the settings for your dashboard. Keep in mind, to access the actual dashboard itself, you're going to want to click on the dashboard button in the upper left-hand corner of the main navigation screen. Localization. Here is where you can change the default formats of dates, times, and currencies. The email tab houses all the tools that manage the email side of your Ontraport account. The email from address setup tool lets you send out emails with Ontraport, but makes it appear as though it's coming from your own personal address. Your IMAP settings will integrate your personal inbox to your account to track correspondence in your contacts logs. Double opt-in and invoice manager is where you'll create and manage message templates for double opt-in email message confirmations and invoices. On to the social tab. Use the Facebook API to integrate your Ontraport and Facebook business accounts for things like deep funnel conversion tracking. And the Facebook tool is what you'll use to set up Facebook opt-in options for your incoming leads. The integrations tab is where you'll set up and manage integrations for platforms like One Shopping Cart, ClickBank, Zapier, UltraCart, and more. You'll also use the Ontraport API instructions and key manager tool to create and delete keys for custom integrations. This is kind of advanced nerdy stuff, so you probably don't have to worry about most of this. The User Management tab is where you'll manage all of your internal team members and their access to your Ontraport account. Add, delete, or modify users and their permissions with the User Management and Team Roles and Permission Management tools. You'll use the Lead Routing tool to route your leads to team members so that they can follow up. The User Field Editor is where you'll edit the user fields in your users' records. The Personalize tab is where you'll customize the way that your Ontraport account looks. You'll do this by reordering the navigation menu or changing the default object view. The Business Info tab houses the settings and tools related to your business, like your name, address, and phone number. These things will show up on your invoices and email footers. The Developer Preferences and Resources tab is where you'll access the tracking code for your account, as well as the partner tracking pixel. You'll need the partner tracking pixel if you want to use a third-party shopping cart and still want to take advantage of Ontraport's partner program feature. The membership tab is where you'll manage membership sites built within Ontraport and on WordPress. We have entire lessons dedicated to these features, so be sure to tune into our membership site series. The Ontraport Marketplace tab is where you'll manage your profile and content to be used and shared within the Ontraport Marketplace. The Advanced Features tab is home to all of the advanced features available to Ontraport users. Toggling any of these switches turns the feature on in your account. The idea here is that if you aren't using a feature, it's best to turn it off to avoid clutter and confusion when navigating around the app. Some of the advanced features include things like systems, deals, companies, and custom objects. Like our other settings and tools, we have entire lessons dedicated to these features, so I encourage you to check those out for more information. The Legacy Features tab contains a list of older, archived Ontraport features. These include things like sequences, postcards, and upsell forms. Toggle them on or off whenever you want, but keep in mind that you'll probably leave them off most of the time. Note that these are older features, and we have updated features that do the same things but better. The security tools enable or disable things like IP restrictions and reCAPTCHAs on your forms. Finally, we have Ontraport Labs. This screen shows experimental Ontraport features that you can turn on if you want an early look at some upcoming features and tools. But keep in mind that these features are listed in Labs for a reason. They can have some unexpected results, so think of them more like a test program. And that, my friends, covers the main tools and settings that you're going to find in the administration and account details sections of your account. If things feel a little overwhelming right now, don't worry about it. I totally get it. But now that you know where these tools live, you can familiarize yourself with them over time. If you're ready to move on, next I'm going to show you all the different support services that we offer our Ontraport users.